Hi everyone, I'm Vaughn, owner and maker of Vaughn Knits, and the host of the fabulous Facebook group Dare to Be Original. And the last episode we made the doll dress, and today we're going to make the accessories, which is the underwear and the shoes, and hopefully if we have time we can do a quick scarf. But we'll see, I might have to make that a bonus video. So how to start with the underwear. We're just going to make a slip knot, wrap around my finger, pull it up, and pull it all the way through. Just a slip knot, and then we're going to chain 19. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19. Let's double check that. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18, 19. Just to quickly show you, I have a G, and already I can tell by this G that my 19 is going to be too big. It'll stretch, and that's about halfway. Maybe not. I'm nervous. I wonder if I should use the... Yeah, it looks... It should be about halfway. I think I'm going to change hooks and make it the E hook. See what that E looks like. This was a G and the yarn is a G, but that seemed very big. Now if you have a bigger hook with a fatter yarn, you can still make the underwear and just don't use these numbers, decrease the numbers. Yeah, I think I feel better with the smaller hook. All right, let's go. 2, 4, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18, 19. And then, yeah, that feels better. You want to go to 18 single crochet, so you're going to skip the first chain and single crochet. So you start off with 19 chains, and when you go into the next row, you skip the first chain. I always chain my edges, so that's where that 19th one comes into play. So you should have 18 single crochets. So I hope you guys enjoyed the last video making the dress from scratch with no designs, no patterns. I've got some positive feedback, so I'm really happy. And I'm even more happy to read that that people are like learning some stuff and gaining confidence from doing something without a pattern. So 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 17, 18 is the last one, and I'm gonna carry up my yarn because I don't do... Oh no, you know what? I'm not gonna carry up my yarn this time around because I'm gonna use this end as a seaming for the one side of the underwear. So we'll leave this end open. So that's 18. So we're going to chain one and then single crochet into that first single crochet. And we do another round of single crochet. Now remember, you can use a thicker yarn and you can just change the numbers depending on how you, what kind of yarn you want to use for the underwear. And I like to use whatever color outfit or color dress I'm doing so that it just becomes matching. And so that's two rounds of single crochet, and that should be 18. Turn around and do one more. We'll do three rounds, three rows of single crochet. I'm coming in hot today because I'm on a time crunch. I have a lot of things happening and I want to get this tutorial recorded and out to everyone that's working on this with me. And so that's three rows with 18 single crochet. And this is a good size for the band. So to turn around, you're not going to chain. We're basically going to slip stitch because we kind of want to crawl our way. We don't want to make any extra stitches. We want to crawl our way over to into the third one. So we're basically slip stitching three times and then we're going to single crochet into the first, into the fourth one. And then single crochet 12 times. So basically we're going to skip the first three. We're going to slip stitch into the first three. And this is a way to do a short row. Technical term. They call it a short row. Because you're not using up all the stitches in that row. So to get to that point, you're going to slip stitch into it. And all the slip stitches is just an overlay of it. So that's 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 11, 12. And then we don't have to do the last three. We're just going to turn around, chain. Oh, sorry, don't chain. We're going to turn around and we're going to decrease. And basically how we do that is you're going to skip the first, oh no, oh wait, I believe I'm going to single crochet into the first one, and single crochet, I think we're decreasing, but we're going to decrease it at the end of the row. So basically, it's 2, 4, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 is our last row. 2, 3, 11. Also, what we want to do is decrease by going into the how you want it. What we want to do is start to decrease our way down. What's the, you know what? I don't think I want to decrease that way. I think I'm going to decrease the other way. There are two ways you can decrease a row. You can I don't want to confuse you guys. Let's go back to the other row again. You can decrease the final row or you can decrease at the beginning of the row. And I think I want to decrease at the beginning of the row. It gives it a smoother edge. So we're back to the other row. I just ripped that back. Boy, you guys are having a fun tutorial with me today, huh? So, we're back to that original row where we had the three. So we did three single crochets, three rows of single crochet of 18. And then we turned around and we slip stitched the first three stitches. And then we did 12 single crochets. So we're going to turn around and we're going to skip that first one and just go single crochet into the next one. So that will leave us to 11 in this round. And I think that's how I want to decrease. I want to skip the first stitch and then go to 11. So that's 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 11. and then turn it over and skip the first stitch. So that's 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. We're going to turn it around, skip the first stitch, so we should have 9 in this round. And then turn around and skip the first stitch, and we'll have 8. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Turn it around, skip the first stitch, and we'll have 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Turn around, skip the first stitch. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Turn around, skip the first stitch. So we should have 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Turn around, skip the first stitch, and we'll have 4. And that's where we want to stop. 2, 3, 4. So that's us decreasing all the way down. And now we're going to turn around and do the opposite, which is increase. Right? So we have 4. And in this next round, we want, so you have 4 in this next round, you want to chain 1. Is it 4? 4, and then, yeah, turn around. And what we're going to, oh no, we don't want to do that. What we want to do here, so we have 4 stitches, and we're going to chain 3. And, oh, no, we don't want to chain 3. Hold on. Let me go back now. So, wait, so we have 4 this way, so we want to turn around, and now we want to increase back out. And so how to do that is we're going to chain 1, and we're basically going to let's do 2 single crochets. We'll increase this way. We'll do 2 single crochets into the first stitch. And then that should give us 5. Turn around. And then chain 1 and do 2 single crochets into the first stitch. And that should give us 6. 6, 2, 3, 4, 5, 2, 4, 6. Turn around, chain 2 single crochets into the first one, and that should give us 7. So it's 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Ooh, yarn splitting on me again. 6, 7. Turn around, chain, and then 2 single crochets into the first stitch. And that should give us 8. And we want to keep this pattern going until we're back to that 12 again. So you're learning a lot in this one. You're decreasing and increasing incrementally. So turn around. I've lost count on what number we're at, so we'll just do it here. We want to do 2 into the first one, see where we're at. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So next one should be 10. So 2 into the first one. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 in the next one. So 2 into the first one. 'Once you get the hang of this, you will be whipping out underwear like crazy for these dolls. Because they're really quick to make. A lot quicker than that dress. But then again, I wasn't really prepared for that dress. If I was prepared, I might have been able to go a little faster. What was that? This one's 11, so I believe it's 11. Oh, sorry. So chain 2 into the first, and this should make it 12. So we'll see what happens. It's 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Excellent. So now that we have 12, we're going to go back to that original, and then that's chaining our 3. That's our the 3 edges that we slip stitch into. So now on the opposite side, we're creating, actually it's chain 4, because you're skipping that first chain and we want to somehow increase 3 extra stitches. So we chain 4 and you skip the first stitch, and then you single crochet back, and that takes you to 3 on one side, and then 12 across, definitely not liking this yarn, it keeps splitting on me. So 12 across, and then we want to chain 3 on this side. Four on this side, because we're skipping that first chain, and we're basically creating, we're back to that 16 or 18 stitches again. So we got 3, 12, and 3 is 18 stitches. And then we're basically going to do the single crochet for 2 to 3 rows. I can't remember. We're just doing a mirror reflection of the other side. And you can change colors, and you can do all kinds of different different designs for this, just like the dress. There's so many possibilities. I can't wait. I hope you guys send me pictures and share it on your social media, and tag me and let me know, tag at Vone Knits, and let me know what you guys are doing, because I would love to see your creativity expressed with this. So basically I just turned around and I'm doing 18 single crochets all the way around. I can't decide if it's 2 to 3 rows. It's got to be 3 or 4, because mind you, it's going to look a little funny because we're increasing one side. So one side's going to be slightly thicker or thinner than the other side. So I just want to do single crochets until we meet up with the other side. And then we'll fold it over and stitch up the side. So So one more row here. So it looks like three rows. Oh yeah, that's exactly what the other side was, three rows, so that makes sense. All right. So this underwear shows you how to do decreases and increases. You guys are going to be pros by the time you're done. Actually, I think a lot of you are already pros. So, oh, that's good. We landed at the right spot too, because on this side, we can just go ahead and slip stitch. And then on the other side, we'll just use that to whip stitch it. And so how I seam this close when I have the yarn still in here, I'm basically just gonna chain one, right? You fold it over, chain one, and then you stick it in this one and you stick it in the other one, and then just slip stitch that close, stick it in here, just slip stitch that in there, and into the last one, you get the edge there, slip stitch it in there, chain one, and then cut it off, and that sews your one end together, and then we'll whip stitch that close. And then on the other side, we already had the end, so glad I didn't weave in that end. And then we can just whip stitch this close on this side. Whenever you're whip stitching, you just want to pay attention and make sure that you have, like, you get the very edge nice and secure. That's all. Because that's where, like, it's going to keep opening and closing, so you want to make sure you got the edge part real good. And once you do that, you're set. And then all I'm going to do is stick this back in here and then weave in this end on this side. We're going to flip this underwear over and make it the other side as the front, as the outside. So that's why you're doing all the action on this side. And then maybe one more back. That should be nice and secure. Just cut that off on this side. Weave in the end. I'll just pay attention to that, this corner edge. Just make sure it's nice and tight. Just to reinforce it, because that's where, like, it's going to go in and out of the doll. So you don't really have to do this. I'm just trying to move this up. And then just weave in the end here. This needle's too fat for this stitch. And then back one more for a couple of stitches. If you're doing this for a child, especially like a young child to be playing with it all the time, you want to make it a little bit more durable. But this is nice and secure. And I'm doing this doll for an adult, so I'm not too worried about it getting dismantled. So that's the inside. And then you just fold it out. And voila, there's your underwear. And what I normally do is I have a tag, and I usually just stick it on the back of, that's where I put my tag on for the doll. And then you just slide it up her legs here, and it should go right up. And I'm glad I went with the smaller needle. I went with the E hook for that G, because I had a feeling that was pretty loose when I did use that G. And there's her underwear, and that's pretty quick and easy. And that's the underwear. Okay, so now we're gonna do the shoe. And we start the shoe off by making a magic circle. And I'm still using the E-hook, just like the same as the underwear. And you're gonna wrap it on your finger, pull it up, and then quickly chain to catch it. And we wanna make 8 single crochets around the ring. 8 single crochets around the ring. And we're doing the magic loop so we can tighten it up. So it's 2, 4, 6, 7, 8. And we'll tighten up the circle. Just double count there, 2, 4, 6, 8. And then I'm gonna stick my fancy stitch marker right there so I know I'm at the beginning of the circle. And we want to increase by a double, so we're going to do 2 single crochets into the same single crochet. So that'll take us to 16 by the time we're done. So that's 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Tighten up my circle there. 7, 8, and I'm just weaving in my end as I go, or crocheting over my ends as I go. 2, 4, 6, 8. 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, and 16. And then just single crochet over every single one for, I want to say, about 8 rows. So let's just keep single crocheting. I'm not positive. We just want to go around the foot until and we're just basically working in a spiral going. Still weaving in over my ends. So this pattern is adjustable, because all you're trying to basically do is make a bunch of make a circle and keep going around and around until you get to about the foot size. So you can change yarns. You can use fancy yarns to make a big boot. And depending on how high or low you do the next part, you can make it look like socks. You can make it look like knee-high boots. You can do all kinds of stuff. Or you can do a simple shoe and just look like a slipper, you know. So there's lots of room for creativity when it comes to this one. So all you're doing is you start off with 8, double to 16, and then just keep going for, I want to say, 8 rows. But I'm not positive. I'm just not positive until I actually just do it. But whatever you do, the important thing is it's okay to wing it. Whatever you do to one side, make sure you do the exact same thing to the other shoe. But by then, I already have the other shoe to compare it to, so I'll be able to just lift it up and go, oh, how big is that? And then I just measure it up and go, okay, there's that big. So it's that many rows, and then I move on. Oops, excuse me. I keep hitting the camera. All right, good. I'm over all my ends. I usually don't make it that long, but I went really long on that end, and I probably could have cut it, but clearly I didn't. So I hope you guys are, what do you guys think about this being almost done? And then I have a new adventure that I'm going to do. So I'm excited about completing this whole doll series. I'm excited that you guys are making them, and I'm excited that you guys are sharing me pictures along the way. I love watching different ideas happen. I love watching other people's interpretations of, that's why I love knit and crochet. I love handmade crafts. I love that people can learn a pattern and they do something so different on their own, and they're doing this exact same thing, same stitches, same concept, but when you take your own colors that you like, or take your own yarn type that you like, change the needle size up and down, it transforms everything, and it becomes so unique and special. That's what I love about handmade. And it's funny because I hear everybody in this community, the handmade community, where they're like so gun shy about sharing their stuff, because I think they're like so afraid that someone's gonna steal their work. I'm like, how can somebody steal your work? It's your hands, your own creativity. Whatever they're doing their own thing, you know. I just don't understand it. I think the only way somebody can actually steal my work is if they somehow drugged me up and tied my hands and made my hands do something else. Then maybe that would be stealing. But other than that, whatever people do, that's their own creativity. Let me see where we're at. So we're at the beginning of the row. So it's 2, 4, 6. Oh, is it 6? Yeah. 7. Let's go one more row. See what I mean about? So one more round. So 16 more single crochets, and I'll show you how to make the back of the shoe. That's 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. That takes us back to the beginning. Just make sure I didn't miscount somewhere, because I feel like I'm over the line there. Again, this yarn. Alright, so it's 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, and yeah, so that's 7 rounds. So it's 2, 4, 6, 7. So 7 rounds, and then turn it around and chain 1, and then single crochet into that first stitch. It's 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. So go around 11 and then turn it around, chain 1, and we're going to go back. So we have 11 to do as the back. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 10, 11, turn it around, chain one, single crochet again. I think we're doing this for 5 rows, the backing. This is our 3rd row. Turn it around again, chain one and the single crochet, so this is the 4th row. And then for the 5th row, I can't remember if it's the 5th or the 4th, so 5th or the 6th, but I have a feeling it's the 5th one here. Just want to double check. That was 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 rows. Oh, it is. Awesome. Awesome. So for the 5th row, what you want to do is you're going to take the, you're going to flip this around and we're going to basically seam up the row. So you want to chain and you're basically going to fold it over and and you want to single, do you see how what that is, what I'm doing there? I'm sealing it up, but I'm sealing it from the other side, so you're going to stick it in here in between the both of them and slip stitch it right through. So it's only 4 chains around, and see how you go on all 4 of these. And what you're actually doing in this step is you're binding off the edge. And then just chain the last one that closes it up. And then there's your shoe. See? Did I make that too small? Oh, I might have made that. Maybe we have to go 5 rows or we stretch it. Let's see if this fits her foot. Maybe it's 4. Maybe it was 5, like my initial thought. Let's see if we can get a shoe in here. Oh, you know what? 4 is good. It fits. Secrecy. We can pull that out. So there, that's her shoe. Now, this is just a regular slip shoe. What you can do to make it fancy is you can, we can weave this part in, and then what you can do if you wanted to make socks or like boots to go all the way up, you can use the same color. So imagine if you use this in black, like black boots, that would be really cute. But I think I'm gonna do the other color and make it like socks or a trimming upward, and I think that'll make it look cute. I'm gonna get rid of this tag because it bothers me. I hate ends like with a passion, so I will do anything to get rid of my ends. Oh, I don't want to do that. I just want to stitch. So what you can do is, as an alternative, or add more flair into it, is pick up another color or the same color if you're gonna like make black boots or blue boots, knee-high boots, all the way up. Always start off in the back because you never know where your mistakes are. So you always want to start off in the back, and you chain. So you go into there and you chain one. And that'll start. I'm not sure how many stitches it is. So we're going to single crochet. Actually, to be even faster, I'm just going to double crochet my way up around this shoe. Double crochet just because it gives it a nice thicker edge, but it also lets me not double crochet, I'm sorry, half double. Just because I want to fill it up a little bit. And you just want to, you want to smartly go around every hole that you can get into, but you don't want to, you want to be careful that you're going around enough. I don't remember how many stitches it is, but you want to safely go around where you're not actually making too many, unless that's the design that you want. You can have like a fluffier edging, and you're just going to basically single crochet around. Once I get over this edge, I'll be able to have a better eye of what's happening. And I'm essentially making the trim of the shoe, but almost like it's the sock. Sometimes I like a clean little shoe with the outfit, depending on how fancy the dress is or how fancy the outfit, but you can really play around with these shoes. And once I go around, I'll give you an idea of just about how far, how many stitches I went around there. Oh, yeah, that went, that looks really cute. So what is that? 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16. Actually, that's genius, because it was not what we went around the other way, so it's perfect. So we're going to slip stitch into the beginning. You can make another row or end it. So slip stitch. Do I want to make another row? I think I'm going to end it because I think I like this one better. I don't know. Oh, let me see. Maybe I'll do one more row. Chain one, half double. Let's go around one more row. Let's make a nice, thick, colorful border. Almost like higher socks. Slightly higher socks. So it ended up being 16 around. And evenly distribute that around so it works off into a nice circle. And then you're just going to go ahead and repeat the other shoe. It does not look like I have time to make the scarf in this video. So what I'll do is, I'll do a bonus video for the scarf afterwards. So it's two rounds of half double crochet. And can you imagine if you took like one of those fancy fluffy yarn? Like how cute would that look? And that would make it like a cute, boot cuffs, right? Somebody do that. Somebody make a really cool boot cuff and send me a picture. And we'll weave in this end and I'll show you what her feet looks like. And ta-da, so we got the underwear, and we got the shoe with the socks and the fancy socks, and it goes right in there. And how cute does she look? Right? Oh, I'm excited. I hope Christy likes this doll. All right, guys, so that's the underwear and the shoes, and I'll have to come back later for the scarf. So if you like this video, thumbs up please, and if you haven't subscribed, you should be already subscribed. And until next time, Have a good one. Bye. Hi everyone, I'm Vaughn, owner and maker of Vaughn Knits, and the host of the fabulous Facebook group Dare to Be Original. And the last episode we made the doll dress, and today we're going to make the accessories, which is the underwear and the shoes, and hopefully if we have time we can do a quick scarf. But we'll see, I might have to make that a bonus video. So how to start with the underwear. We're just going to make a slip knot, wrap around my finger, pull it up, and pull it all the way through. Just a slip knot, and then we're going to chain 19. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19. Let's double check that. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18, 19. Just to quickly show you, I have a G, and already I can tell by this G that my 19 is going to be too big. It'll stretch, and that's about halfway. Maybe not. I'm nervous. I wonder if I should use the... Yeah, it looks... It should be about halfway. I think I'm going to change hooks and make it the E hook. Let's see what that E looks like. This was a G and the yarn is a G, but that seemed very big. Now if you have a bigger hook with a fatter yarn, you can still make the underwear and just don't use these numbers, decrease the numbers. Yeah, I think I'm gonna, I feel better with the smaller hook. All right, let's go. 2, 4, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18, 19. And then, yeah, that feels better. You want to go to 18 single crochet, so you're going to skip the first chain and single crochet. So you start off with 19 chains, and when you go into the next row, you skip the first chain. I always chain my edges, so that's where that 19th one comes into play. So you should have 18 single crochets. So I hope you guys enjoyed the last video making the dress from scratch with no designs, no patterns. I've got some positive feedback, so I'm really happy. And I'm even more happy to read that that people are like learning some stuff and gaining confidence from doing something without a pattern. So 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 17, 18 is the last one, and I'm gonna carry up my yarn because I don't do... Oh no, you know what? I'm not gonna carry up my yarn this time around because I'm gonna use this end as a seaming for the one side of the underwear. So we'll leave this end open. So that's 18. So we're going to chain one and then single crochet into that first single crochet. And we do another round of single crochet. Now remember, you can use a thicker yarn and you can just change the numbers depending on how you, what kind of yarn you want to use for the underwear. And I like to use whatever color outfit or color dress I'm doing so that it just becomes matching. And so that's two rounds of single crochet, and that should be 18. turn around and do one more. We'll do three rows of single crochet. I'm coming in hot today because I'm on a time crunch. I have a lot of things happening and I want to get this tutorial recorded and out to everyone that's working on this with me. And so that's three rows with 18 single crochet. And this is a good size for the band. So to turn around, you're not going to chain. We're basically going to slip stitch because we kind of want to crawl our way. We don't want to make any extra stitches. We want to crawl our way over to into the third one. So we're basically slip stitching three times and then we're going to single crochet into the first, into the fourth one. And the single crochet 12 times. So basically we're going to skip the first three. We're going to slip stitch into the first three. And this is a way to do a short row. Technical term, they call it a short row because you're not using up all the stitches in that row. So to get to that point, you're going to slip stitch into it, and all the slip stitches is just an overlay of it. So that's 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 11, 12, and then we don't have to do the last three. We're just going to turn around, chain. Oh, sorry, don't chain. We're going to turn around and we're going to decrease. And basically how we do that is you're going to skip the first, oh no, no wait, I believe I'm going to single crochet into the first one and single crochet. I think we're decreasing, but we're going to decrease it at the end of the row. So basically, it's 2, 4, 6, 7, 8, 9. Turn around and do the opposite, which is increase. Right? So we have 4. And in this next round, we want, so you have 4 in this next round, you want to chain 1, is it 4? 4, and then, yeah, turn around, and what we're going to, oh no, we don't want to do that. What we want to do here, so we have 4 stitches, and we're going to chain 3, and oh, no, 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 we don't want to chain 3. Hold on. Let me go back now. So, wait, so we have 4 this way. So we want to turn around, and now we want to increase back out. And so how to do that is we're going to chain 1, and we're basically going to let's do 2 single crochets. We'll increase this way. We'll do 2 single crochets into the first stitch. And then that should give us 5. Turn around. And then chain 1 and do 2 single crochets into the first stitch. And that should give us 6. 6, 2, 3, 4, oh, 5, 2, 4, 6. Two single, turn around, chain 2 single crochets into the first one, and that should give us 7. So it's 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, ooh, yarn splitting on me again, 6, 7, turn around, chain, and then 2 single crochets into the first stitch. And that should give us 8. And we want to keep this pattern going until we're back to that 12 again. So you're learning a lot in this one. You're decreasing and increasing incrementally. So turn around. I've lost count on what number we're at, so we'll just do it here. We want to do 2 into the first one, see where we're at. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So next one should be 10. So 2 into the first one. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 in the next one, so 2 into the first one. 'Once you get the hang of this, you will be whipping out underwear like crazy for these dolls. Because they're really quick to make. A lot quicker than that dress. But then again, I wasn't really prepared for that dress. If I was prepared, I might have been able to go a little faster. What was that? This one's 11, so I believe it's 11. Oh, sorry. So chain 2 into the first, and this should make it 12. So we'll see what happens. It's 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. 12. Excellent. So now that we have 12, we're going to go back to that original, and then that's chaining our 3. That's our the 3 edges that we slip stitch into. So now on the opposite side, we're creating, actually it's chain 4, because you're skipping that first chain and we want to somehow increase 3 extra stitches. So we chain 4 and you skip the first stitch, and then you single crochet back, and that takes you to 3 on one side, and then 12 across, definitely not liking this yarn, it keeps splitting on me. So 12 across, and then we want to chain 3 on this side. 4 on this side, because we're skipping that first chain, and we're basically creating, we're back to that 16 or 18 stitches again. So we got 3, 12, and 3 is 18 stitches. And then we're basically going to do the single crochet for 2 to 3 rows. I can't remember. We're just doing a mirror reflection of the other side. And you can change colors, and you can do all kinds of different different designs for this, just like the dress. There's so many possibilities. I can't wait. I hope you guys send me pictures and share it on share it on your social media and tag me and let me know. Tag at Vone Knits and let me know what you guys are doing, because I would love to see your creativity expressed with this. So basically I just turned around and I'm doing 18 single crochets all the way around. I can't decide if it's 2 to 3 rows. It's got to be 3 or 4, because mind you, it's going to look a little funny because we're increasing one side. So one side's going to be slightly thicker or thinner than the other side. So I just want to do single crochets until we meet up with the other side, and then we'll fold it over and stitch up the side. So one more row here. So it looks like 3 rows. Oh yeah, that's exactly what the other side was, 3 rows, so that makes sense. All right, 10. 11 is our last row, 2, 3, 11. Also, what we want to do is decrease by going into the, what we want to do is start to decrease our way down. What's the, you know what? I don't think I want to decrease that way. I think I'm going to decrease the other way. There are two ways you can decrease a row. You can I don't want to confuse you guys. Let's go back to the other row again. You can decrease the final row, or you can decrease at the beginning of the row. And I think I want to decrease at the beginning of the row. It gives it a smoother edge. So we're back to the other row. I just ripped that back. Boy, you guys are having a fun tutorial with me today, huh? So we're back to that original row where we had the three. So we did 3 rows of single crochet of 18. And then we turned around and we slip stitched the first 3 stitches. And then we did 12 single crochets. So we're going to turn around and we're going to skip that first one and just go single crochet into the next one. So that will leave us to 11 in this round. And I think that's how I want to decrease. I want to skip the first stitch and then go to 11. So that's 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 11. And then turn it over and skip the first stitch. So that's 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. We're going to turn it around, skip the first stitch, so we should have 9 in this round. And then turn around and skip the first stitch, and we'll have 8. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Turn it around, skip the first stitch, and we'll have 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Turn around, skip the first stitch. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Turn around, skip the first stitch. So we should have 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Turn around, skip the first stitch, and we'll have 4. And that's where we want to stop. 1, 2, 3, 4. So that's us decreasing all the way down. And now we're going to turn